Just look at it. Bask in its magnificence for a bit. I'll wait. Okay, that's enough time. I know what you're thinking. What is this astonishing graphics card? Well, I'm glad you asked. What you're looking at is the Radeon HD 6350. In essence, an HD 5450 with a name change. But who cares about that? The real question is, can it game? Well, a quick look at the heatsink should give you a hint to its retina-melting PC Master Race capabilities. Uh-huh. Right. But for real, here are the specs. The Radeon HD 6350 is a bottom, and I mean bottom-end graphics card that was released by AMD in February of 2011. It has a whopping 80 shading units, 8 texture mapping units, 4 ROPs, and 512 megabytes of GDDR5. DDR3 memory. The core is also clocked at a blistering 650 MHz with the double data rate memory running at 800 MHz. Translation? Well, it's kind of terrible. But on the plus side, it sips on only 19 watts, had a launch price of only $23, so basically the same price as a Starbucks latte, and it's DirectX 11 compatible. So does the Radeon HD 6350 have what it takes to game? Let's find out. The first game in our suite of tests is Half-Life 2 running at 720p with mainly the high presets enabled, minus water and shading details. And as you can see, it's running quite well. Not that Half-Life 2 is a terribly difficult game to run, but it is running it well at a smooth frames per second, and we're only using about half of the available memory. I've also upped the core clock from 650 to 750 MHz, and the memory clock from 800 MHz to 1000 even, just to give this graphics card a fighting chance. And as you can see, this graphics card is sufficient to run Half-Life 2. We recorded an average FPS of about 98, a minimum of 47, and a maximum of 260. The next game on our list is Portal 2. This is a fun game that is still pretty easy to run. This is also running at 720p, with more or less the medium preset selected. As you can see, this also runs quite well. We recorded an average FPS of 67, a minimum of 40, and a maximum of 120. As you can see, we've pretty much already maxed out the memory available. It's really close to 500 megabytes. You wouldn't be able to push the settings much higher without running into some serious frame issues. But Portal 2 also runs well and is also a success. And because no budget card benchmark suite would be complete without it, here is Counter-Strike Global Offensive running at 720p at basically the minimum settings. We are playing offline with bots and are getting a pretty decent frames per second. In CSGO, we recorded an average FPS of 58, a minimum of 34, and a maximum of 266, and we are also staying well below the memory limit for this graphics card, hovering at around 300 megabytes. I'd have to say that CSGO is also playable, and actually a fairly enjoyable experience with this graphics card. Next, I wanted to try a slightly newer game, but a game that I also know is fairly easy to run, and this would be Dirt Rally, running at 720p with everything, literally as low as it'll go. There are a few settings that, even after selecting the ultra-low preset, can go down even further, and so you'd want to make sure to do that. And as you can see, it's running quite well, but as you can also see, the memory usage is basically capped out, but overall it runs pretty smoothly. It doesn't look the greatest, but it runs quite smoothly. It also depends on what camera view you have on your vehicle. I found that that can change the FPS quite drastically, actually, with this graphics card. But after running the CAN benchmark, we got an average of 54 frames per second with a minimum of 37 and a maximum of 83. But I've also heard that the built-in benchmark can sometimes give you higher numbers than what you'll see in-game, so I decided to test it out in-game on Pike's Peak, and even here the frames per second was stable and it was a smooth and pleasant experience. However, this game is extremely hard to play with the keyboard, as you can see here. The last game we are testing today is Borderlands 2, one of my all-time favorite games. This is running at 800 by 600p, and everything turned down as far as it'll go. So it looks pretty awful, actually. It's not terribly enjoyable to play when the graphics are turned down this badly. However, you're still able to play Borderlands 2 quite comfortably. With everything cranked down, I was able to get an average of 37, a minimum of 15, and a maximum of 51. So while this isn't the smoothest running game in the world, I would also have to say that a Radeon HD 6350 will play this game. Not very well, but it will play it. So, verdict time. Would I recommend buying the Radeon HD 6350? In a word, no. Unless you're able to get it for an extremely small amount of money and you're on an extremely tight budget, or you just don't care about gaming. If all you're looking for is a basic display adapter, this could be a viable option for you. But otherwise, if you're more of a gaming enthusiast, or if you're just trying to get a foothold in the PC Master Race life, I would definitely look for a different option. Anyways, thank you so much for watching, guys. I hope you found this video entertaining and somewhat helpful. And if you did, I'd really appreciate it if you could toss me a like and maybe even subscribe for more, hopefully, entertaining and beneficial content in the future.